All right. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to today's second match. It's going to be between Fink and Guard Officers. Now, you're probably confused because this isn't exactly the finals. No, this is a kind of semi-finals in the losers bracket. Technically a finals, not really a finals. It's a bit complicated. Basically, it's like this. So, in the last match, we saw the finals in the winner bracket between Verve and Arcade, in which, well, Verve just completely dominated Arcade in all three matches. I've never seen a wipeout so quick and so hurtful. Ow! But here's the thing, Arcade is not out of the battle yet, because this one is going to... This battle here now is going to decide who is going to go up against Arcade tomorrow. Yes. Now, between Fink and Guard Officers, whoever loses this match is out of the tournament. Just bye. You can pack your packs, you're not going to China. Whoever wins this battle, however, is going to tomorrow face off against Arcade. And whoever wins that battle is then going to face off against Verve in the Grand Finale. And whoever wins the Grand Finale is then going to China to win $11,000. Don't complain, it wasn't me who made the system. Anyways, what can I tell you about Fink and GOF? Now, Fink and GOF are two very, very strong teams. But I must say, I'm kind of rooting for GOF here, for one very simple reason. If you followed the stream so far, GOF is not known for taking out any aircraft. I think in the whole tournament, I've only seen them taking out aircraft once. Once! And it was against... who was that? Let me just quickly check. I think it was against Dislike. Yes, they had a very, very clutch game against Dislike, where they won 2... Actually, where they won 3-2. Fink, on the other hand, well, they are a very versatile team. And it's going to be interesting to see these two teams facing off. Now, the first battle is going to be on Poland, it seems, where we see the beautiful, beautiful Stalinwood trees. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the original birthplace of Stalinwood. Strong Polish Stalinwood. This is where we make our IACs and the T-34s. Yes, the T-34s are also made of Stalinwood. Oh, this is interesting. We see a Fink squadron with two aircraft and a pan... Ooh, a Panzer IV 70 tank destroyer. A tank destroyer? We have not seen a tank destroyer, like, ever. Really? Actually, we did once, but, well, it didn't go so well for the team. So, let's see the matchup here. We have Fink Squadron with two aircraft in the air, two P-63 C-5s, both with bombs. Now, the P-63 is a very, very versatile and very capable fighter. It has a 37mm cannon, which is more than enough to penetrate a light or medium tank at SPAA. It also carries a single 500 pound bomb, which is enough to take out down the tank. And it is one of the best turn fighters in these kind of battles. Without the bomb, here's the thing, the bomb kind of slows them down. On the other side, well, GOF is known for not taking out any aircraft, like, ever. And it actually surprised me that they this time only took out, that they actually took out NAA this time. Let's take a look at the ground here. GOF is going for C, Fink is going for A, and B, actually. Fink Squadron with Modern AOT and Bess is going the long way around, which is interesting. GOF might take this one first. Oh, I know exactly what they're doing. Fink Squadron is going for the two guys that are going over to B. One bomb dropped. Oh, Neff is down. Neff is down. Meet him, Ether. He is going for Sivers. Can he take him out? Can he take him out? Yeah, that looks like it. And Sivers is down! Fink just completely annihilated GOF's advance over on B, but it's going to give them a massive, massive advantage here. In the meantime, Ubo Shika here from Fink Squadron took A. And the two guys over there are going for B. Yep. Fink is going with the capture tactic here. This is one of the most liked tactics here in Poland. Whilst the two flags in the city are very easy to reach from one another, you can't really defend one another from, well, one another. On the other hand, if you have this flag, A and B, you can very, very, very easily defend A by shooting from the over on B. And they took the perfect tanks for that. Look at this. Modern AOT with the M4A3. Very strong frontal armor, very strong turret armor, and very good gun depression. So, If Sivers isn't able to stop Montanotti from capping B, they're going to have a massive fight on their hands. Filsomat is in trouble here. Oh, look at Filsomat. He is not looking good, is he? Did you take it any damage yet? I can't actually see the damage here, which is, well, annoying. But yeah, Filsomat all alone against Ubojika in the cap circle. Oh, takes a hit. Slight damage to the cannon barrel, nothing too great though. And it seems like Filsomat is having trouble with his turret ring. And Filsomat is down. Ubojika takes the kill against Filsomat. This is a strong start for Fink. This is a very strong start for Fink. Look here. Dodge Harbor. Defensive position against Neff coming in. Fink is still in the cap circle. In the meantime, Modern RUT is going for B. We have Best Paniki in the back also defending. Sivers 1 is trying to advance over on B, but he's too late. He's too late. They already capped B. Meanwhile, Paradox Helling is actually the only one on GOF Squadron who capped. Yes, C is the only flag that GOF Squadron has in their possession right now. And he's the only one defending it. This is not looking good. The entirety of GOF Squadron is, well, most of them are in the spawn zone. And they're going to get spawn sniped by Modern RUT very shortly here. Now let's look at Nevnemamo here. You know, guys, I'm from Germany. I was born in Germany. I live in Portugal. Don't expect me to pronounce Russian names perfectly. Just don't. I would like to see you pronounce that. Actually, let's see. Chippy dropped his bomb. He is not doing anything. Interestingly, Fink Squadron could very easily take the advantage of GF never taken out aircraft. They could very easily spawn into a TBF or a J87 and just, well, wreck GF Squadron completely. But it doesn't look like they need to. It does not look like they need to. Look at the strength. Best Paniki. Oh, there's a battle coming on. Sivers 1 against the Best Paniki. Let's look at this. Sivers hasn't taken any damage yet. Best seems to be in trouble. Yeah. Best is in trouble. But is it going to be enough? Remember, Sivers 1 has two tanks to take out here. It's not only Best, it also has to face up against Modern RUT. And Best is putting up quite a fight here. Now here's the clutch moment. If Sivers 1, and Sivers 1 is pretty much the MVP here. If he is able to take out Best Paniki and Modern RUT, he might just make it. Oh, he side on! Takes a hit, that's his third ring and his gunner down. But he's behind cover, he's going to have some time to repair that. Let's see, the situation is developing on the other side of the river. Yeah, Paradox Helling not moving here. He's just guarding this point here. He's not taking any chances. But they are not even going for it. This might be a bad tactic here. They are counting on Fink Squadron going for C, but Fink doesn't need to. They have two tanks. They really don't need to. And indeed, I feel so mad. A is wide open here. Filsomat is going for the cap. He's going to decap. He has Best Paniki and Modern OT to worry about on the other side. Ooh, can he make it? Yes, yes, he is decapping. Yeah. Oh, nope. That's her. Never mind. I always confuse these tanks here. But yeah, Filsomat actually managed to decap here. He just stopped the bleeding. Now, if he can cap A, they are going to turn this around. Let's look at Filsomat. Oh, critical hit against Aether. Did take any damage in return? It doesn't look like it. It does not look like it. Filsomat going very strong. Aether is in trouble. Another hit. Only the optics though. Nothing too special here. Aether is backing up to repair that damage he took. Let's see what he took. I can't see the damage he took. But he's repairing, so he is in trouble. He is in trouble. And look at this. Ubojika, Paradox Helling facing off against Ubojika, which tries to decap. And it seems like he managed to do so. Paradox Helling is in trouble, it seems. That looks like a dead loader, indeed. That is a dead loader and that damage check, and Paradox Helling is down. Ooh, not good. Ubojika taking the C flag, so they just completely turned this around. GF had a very strong game, very strong turnaround there, trying to go for A, but they lost C in the process. And the nearest player to see is an anti-air vehicle. And they are running out of tanks here. GOF is running out of tanks here. This is not looking good for these guys. Oh. Fink Squadron going very strong here. Just, you can't underestimate these guys, you know? These are the semi-finals here. These guys know how to play. They are very, very, very good. And they just completely wiped out GOF here. GOF now only has a T-44 in the spawn. Getting spawn snapped from the guy from the guys over on the other side. And Paul Rune in the name 19. Who is desperately trying to run away from Wubojika, but... Oh, nope, there's nothing good. His gunner is down, his loader is down, his commander is down. He's just running away now, Trying to get into the sniper, but he made it. He might still be able to fire back, but then again, it's only an AA. How much can he really do? Oh, look at this. Cat and mouse game, and he is down. GOF was eliminated. That seems like a definite 1-0 for Fink Squadron. And take it, ladies and gentlemen. From what we've seen so far, these teams are really, really good, and they just seem to completely wipe out each other one way or another. Now, if you stuck around for the first match today, we saw Verve versus Arcade in the finals of the winners bracket, and Verve just completely dominated Arcade with a 3-0. And we seem to be seeing the same thing here. That's the thing. I really like GOF Squadron. I really, really do. They are excellent players. They're one of the best squadrons in the game right now. But they are very, very, very thick-headed. Like, they do not take out aircraft. They just don't. They just really don't. And that gives them a massive disadvantage in here. Because here's the thing. There are two ways to win these kinds of battles. Either you go for the full cap annihilation, or you, well, destroy every single living thing on the enemy team. Which is my preferred way of playing. But this thing, if you don't have aircraft, you're going to have a very hard time to destroy the enemy team completely before the cap timer runs out. So it's going to be very, very hard for GOF to come back here. Now in the meantime, let's see, whilst the teams are readying up, let's see what map they are going to choose. They haven't chosen any map yet, it seems. Or it might just be the same map, I didn't actually check here. Let me tell you a bit about the squadrons that are facing off. Now, Fink is in loser's bracket because they lost against Arcade. Arcade being the team that was in the finals just an hour ago. And I can understand that. Arcade is a very, very, very strong team. Did kind of disappoint the last match though. Now, I'm not going to be too critical of them, but they were completely wiped out in the 3-0 finals. It's not often that you see that. It really is not often that you see that. After that, they won very easily against Mist. Mist Squadron being a being one of the amateur squads that actually classified through the in-game tournament. I don't know if you guys saw that. 10 of these teams were actually professional esports teams, while 6 were chosen from in-game. So just normal, regular players, and Mist was the best team of them. They actually went very, very far. They made it all the way up to the semi-finals. But they faced off against Fink, and Fink just wiped them out. Just wiped the floor with them. They also knocked out Dynamite. Dynamite being the team that actually won against GOF the first time. Yes, Dynamite was the team that put GOF into the loser's bracket by air domination. Because GOF doesn't like to take out aircraft. Now the next map seems to be Normandy. Yes, indeed. Normandy is a very, very, very interesting map. You get wide open fields on the right side, very close city combat in the middle, and a beach on the left side with a big height difference. Now I'm expecting to see a good mixture of M4A3s on the beach, just because they can take advantage of the hilly terrain with the strong frontal turret armor and very, very good gun depression. And some T-44s and T-34s, and maybe even Tiger E's in the city. We've seen that in the last battle between Verve and Arcade, where Verve actually took out 2 Tiger E's in the last battle in Normandy, and they just completely held the city. Arcade didn't have a chance. They just did not have a chance. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know yet, I'd like to present myself. I am your moderator for today. My name is Mike Gilsroom, and sadly, I'm not joined by anyone. Sean, sadly, is sick at the moment, and he doesn't have a voice, and Tim, also known as Orange Zoom, actually had to go away, so I'm all by myself. Yay! Mommy, I'm scared. So, I really hope that you guys don't mind the single, very accident commentary too much, because, well, it's the best I can do. And I've just ran out of coffee, so let's hope that these matches go over quickly. Now teams are readying up, so this should be starting any moment now. At the moment, the score is 1-0 for GOF. For Fink, sorry about that. GOF actually taking the loss there, and this is going to be very hard for them. Now, I shouldn't be biased. As a commentator, I really should not be biased. But I am. Whilst I really like GOF, they just handicapped themselves way too much by not taking out the aircraft, and Fink is going to take advantage of that. They took advantage of that in the last match, and they are probably going to take advantage of that even more. But here's the thing. Normandy is a very hard map to fly out aircraft in. There are lots of buildings for the tanks to hide behind, and there are some barrage maroons in the air, which the aircraft can crash into, so they can never get a perfect line of attack there. So it's going to be very interesting to see what the teams are going to do in terms of aircraft and tank battle. GOF might actually have the slight advantage here in this battle. So, team lineups are the same. Chippy actually going... Oh, very ballsy there. Chippy definitely going for the TBF1C. They just know that GOF is not going to bring them any aircraft, any position in terms of aircraft. Scores are now updated, so let's see how this develops. Yeah, team lines are pretty much what I predicted. Lots of Russian tanks on GOF. Ooh, that's an interesting tactic. Russian tanks aren't exactly the best thing to take out in the beach fights. And we see Feels So Mad over there on the beach, capping now the native B flag. But it's going to have to worry about Chippy and the CBF1C very, very soon. Let's look at a quick overview here. Oh! Look at that! Okay, I'm eating my own words. Psalm actually took out an aircraft with a bomb! That is surprising. That is very surprising. GOF definitely seems to have learned from their mistakes, but then again, Psalm, as far as I know, is really the only aircraft flyer in the GOF esports team. Now, of course, he has an advantage over the TBF1C. No doubt about that. The TBF is not a fighter, but, and that's a very big but, a very massive, big and round but. TP is already very close, and he already has to drop his bombs. He has no use after he goes after. Oh! We see some fire here. Yeah. Psalm going after Chippy. This is a dogfight between a P63 and a TBF1C. Chippy apparently seems to bet on his gunner, but he's all... Oh, that's a right wing gone. Paul Laruna in the M19 actually took him out. Very good play there, very good. SPA actually doing something here. Now, scores are still pretty even. Both GOF and Fink Squadron have one flag each. Psalm, which one is he going to go for? He seems to be going for either. Yes. And he missed his bomb. And it was the only bomb he could take out. Ooh, this is not looking good. Now, Psalm can land on the airfield and try to rearm, but the airfield is very far away. And he's going for the wrong side. Oh no, actually he's going for Chippy. Chippy just spawns into another P63. He's going to try and intercept Chippy here. Let's look at this. Yeah. Very good maneuvering here. Now, Psalm has the advantage here because he doesn't have a bomb, but Chippy has a bomb. Chippy is in disadvantage here. Psalm is more maneuverable. I'm really going to see that happen here. Yeah, Psalm is right behind him. Chippy has to do something or he's going to lose this battle. Oh, look at this. Hold on. Fink actually went for the cap. Fink took this moment of... just went for the A cap. It's going to be very hard for GOF now to take this back. A is one of the hardest points to capture. And Modern EOT in his T-44 just took that advantage here. Now GOF is going very, very, very close here. They have Sir and Feel So Mad on this side trying to flank around, but they have Ugo Zika on the other side there to face off against. Is Sir even seeing him? Yeah, Sir must have seen him. They also have Dirt Traub behind him, who's actually flanking around and took out Sir! Supers 1, actually. Dirt Traub just flanked around and took out Supers 1. That is one less tank for GOF. This is not looking good. In the meantime, Fink actually lost their aircraft. Chippy was taken out by Psalm. Psalm is still in the air, but then again, Just one less player to mount, because Tong is completely useless right now. He has to go back to the airbase, he has to go back and rearm it, he only gets a single bomb. And if he misses that one again, it's going to be very hard for him to do difference here. GOF is... well, they are at disadvantage on the ground and they have no air support at the moment. Let's see how this develops. Now, very, very, very coordinated events here. Neff and Paradoxalion going both for A. Yes, they are quite hesitant though. They have Dirt Trouble on the left side, which is not looking them. Oh, Dirt Trouble takes it from behind. Dirt Trouble takes it from behind. That's a damaged engine and turret ring. He's side on to Neff and nope, he is down. That was a kind of a, well, he couldn't really see the guys, but alright, here's the thing. Modern OT is now facing off against Neff. Neff takes a shot there. Damaged turret ring, damaged loader. His loader is down. Neff taking this time to get beyond cover, so Modern just bugs his team a couple more seconds. This is going to be decisive here. In the meantime, Paradoxalion is going around trying to flank Modern OT. Whilst, oh, Neff was taken down. Neff was taken down. That cover was not enough. Modern OT with a very, very accurate fire here. Now, Neff is the... oh, Neff is in trouble here. Neff is in trouble here. He has Paniki on his left side. And, ooh, this is bad, this is bad. He's going to get pincer moved here. He's taking advantage of this cover, though. Hit against Modern OT. Modern OT is now a damaged turret ring. A damaged engine is on fire. Taken from behind. Is he actually going to chase him off? Yep. Modern OT is down. But... oh, Paradoxalion is getting some visiting by Bess here. And he is damaged, his cannon breach is down, he has to repair, he can't fire back. This is nothing good here. The only thing Bess has to do is flank around, he can just shoot at this guy all day because he can't fire back. Oh, Bess takes a shot from behind! Where did that come from? No, seriously, where did that come from? Oh no! Trying to snipe Paradoxalion, actually damaged his own teammate there. He just set his own teammate on fire. Now, gladly, it wasn't too bad, but he just wasted a charge on the fire extinguisher. In the meantime, Pulo Ronin was also taken down. He did manage to decap, slowing the bleed. Well, completely stopping the bleed. But look at this. This is not looking good. GOF only has 3 players left at the moment. Look at this, they're already down 3 players. This is not looking good for GOF. Jotro, but in the meantime, all again, capping A. They are just pushing this bleed here. GOF has to move. They can't afford to lose any tanks, but they can't afford to stay still and just lose by points here. Now Psalm in the meantime actually went for the TBF1C. This is interesting, they actually went for 2 aircraft in this match. GOF is definitely trying to surprise us here, but it is not working out so well. Harrow Spice just took out Feel So Mad. Let's look at Harrow Spice. Where is he? Actually, I can see him. Harrow Spice was actually taken out as well. Yes! Oh, Feel So Mad and Harrow Spice actually took each other out. That's why. Let's see. Best actually going for the TPUF. Psalm, can he drop some bombs? He drops one bomb on Eivor. Critical hit, but did not take him out. He takes out Best Paniki, though. He does take out Best Paniki. But is it going to be enough? Fingers still has way too many tanks. Yeah, it seems like he's going for Ubojike, but he has to watch out. Going for Ubojike? Yeah, perfect bomb placement. Ubojike is down. Now does Tom still have a single bomb left, or is he all out? It seems like he still has a bomb. Yes, it seems like he still has a bomb. He is going for Dirt Trouble here. Nope. Bad approach. That was not good. Nope, someone still has to watch out here. It can be shut down any moment. These tanks are very capable. They've shown before that they can take them out. And it seems like Psalm is out of bombs. Yes, he's not coming back. Psalm is out of bombs. In the meantime, let's see how this develops. Pole, ooh. Very ballsy play here, very ballsy play. Pole trying to turn this around, but he has 2 enemies on each side. Fink just lost another tank. GF is actually going strong in tanks here. Might he still turn this around? Come on, if Paul can take this guy down, they might still win this. Fink now only has 1 tank left. Fink has only 1 tank left. Look at the tickets. Eivor is all Fink has now. Eivor is all they have. Oh, but look at the points. And Eivor is down. Eivor is down. GF stopped the bleeding. GF just stopped the bleeding. They... oh, don't tell me that GF is going to do... no. No, this can't be. This can't be. Arfink out. Arfink out. This is the question here. No, Ivar is still, he still has one respawn left. He can't still spawn in. And he spawns in LA 7. Nope, this is nothing good. Nope, 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 nope. Ladies and gentlemen, DOF might have just pulled off the most epic comeback we've seen yet so far in this tournament. Look at this, look at the points, look at the scores. 451 tickets left. And they just turned us around. They capped A. They just reversed the cap here. And they just almost eliminated Fink Squadron. Ivar is now the only player left alive who can do anything. But he only has one set of bombs against four tanks. It is nearly impossible for Fink Squadron to win this one. Oh my god. What is he trying to do here? He seems to be going for field some mad, but this really is just a consolidation kill. He can't really do much. All he can do is try to stop field some mad from, and he doesn't even take out field some mad. Oh my, oh my, this is bad. This is bad. Yep, this is a definite win for GOF. They're now closing in onto the last cap. Ivar is now unable to do anything against the tanks. Some actually went to the P63 just, well, giving him something to fight for. This is pretty much all we can watch right now. GOF definitely won this battle. Alright, let's look at this battle between Fink and GOF. Some, Ivar, oh, look at this, look at this. Oh, that was very close. Some almost took him out, just adding insult to injury. Ivar does not manage to damage Psalm there. This is not looking good for them. Ivar actually has slight damage to his aileron, and he has the less maneuverable aircraft. Psalm does not have any bombs, does he? No, Psalm does not have any bombs, so he is the more maneuverable aircraft here. If they keep it on into a turn fight, Psalm is probably going to take this one. That's exactly what they are doing right now. This is intense. This is intense. Now I must give props to Ivar here. Even though they have no chance of winning this game, they're still giving us some. They're still giving us a fight. You know, this is exactly what this is all about. Sportsmanship. You can't never give up. You can never give up. You always have to keep the show going. Look at this. Who's going to take out first? But look at the points. The game is just about to end here. The game is just about to end. Can we still see an aircraft battle here? Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! And no, he misses his shots. He misses his shots. GOF takes the win. Ladies and gentlemen, my heart is pounding and I hope yours is as well. Did anyone expect this? Seriously, write it in the comments right now. Did anyone expect this? I know I didn't. GOF just turned this around completely. My god. Up until the last minutes here, it looked like GOF was going to lose this one. But they didn't. They turned it around perfectly. Just a clutch turnaround. Ladies and gentlemen, if you just tuned in, welcome to Fink vs. GOF. These are the, well, kind of finals? You can say these are finals. These are the finals in the losers bracket. Whoever wins this battle is going to go up against the losers of the last match, which was Verve vs. Arcade. So whoever wins this battle is going to go up against Arcade. And whoever wins that one is going to go up against Verve in the final, in the very final, the grand final of Thunder Cup. And oh my god, we've seen some battles today. In the first match, Verve just completely annihilated Arcade with a 3-0 win. 3-0 in the finals match. Yes, you heard that right. And today we are seeing some very, very intense battles here. Fink took the first battle against GOF. I think it was on... Which map was it on? It was on Poland, yeah. First map on Poland. Fink completely annihilated GOF. Second map, it looked like Fink was going to annihilate GOF again on Normandy, but they turned it completely around. GOF just clutched the game. With 400 tickets left, they capped, they stopped bleeding, and they annihilated Fink Squadron. And the next battle is going to be on Poland. So we're going to see some repeats here. Now, it's going to be interesting to see what GOF is going to do here. Now, we've seen this once before. We've seen this once before. I think it was GOF versus Dynamite. Yes, where Dynamite took the first battle on Poland by exactly the same tactics that that Fink did it right now. And then they tried to play for Poland again, and GOF just turned it completely around. GOF just dominated them on Poland. Because the one thing I must say about GOF, they are just some very good players. They know exactly what they are doing. And once they handicap themselves by not taking out aircraft, they know how to turn the situation around. You saw the last battle. They know how to take a match around. They just know how to reverse it completely on the enemy. They know how to surprise the enemy. And even though they very rarely take out aircraft, I can't even say never, because they actually took out two aircraft last battle. They still dominate. They can still dominate. So it's all going to be about who takes the first minutes of the match. Poland again, a very interesting map as well. We have some city combat on A and C, and the B flag over on the other side. And so far we've seen two tactics. Either you go for the city and go for A and C, try to hold them both, which is kind of difficult. What A and C are more easily accessible from one to another, they are also very hard to defend from one place to another. On the other hand, you have B and A, which are very easy to defend from one side to the other. So at the moment we can only see Nev. Nev seems to be only one in. Ladies and gentlemen, we seem to have some trouble here. Yes, Nev just wrecked themselves. It seems like Fink Squadron did not connect. Yeah, we'll have to restart this match. Sorry about the technical difficulties here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's actually get back to the hangar here. What may help the seniors that one of the teams did not have a player connect. We've seen this once before. If one of the players doesn't connect at the start of the match, they restart the match pretty much. They all back out, very good sportsmanship, and give the player time to connect and to get back into the game. So let's just quickly check what's happening here. Players are ready again. Yes, it seems like one of the players had disconnected here. Dutch Trouble from Fix Squadron is apologizing for a restart here. In the meantime, both teams are ready, still on Poland, still Fink versus GOF. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Michaels Boom, and I'm your only commentator for today. And I'm getting kind of a sore throat here. Let's just hope that one of these teams takes this win very early, because I am running out of voice here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you like these streams, do let us know. Follow the War Thunder channel. Tell us in the chat how much you like us or dislike us. Hey, if you dislike us, that's perfectly fine. But then again, I don't know why we would be watching us right now. Also, you have Twitter to hit us up. You have YouTube channels. You have lots of places where you can tell us your feelings. These battles are going. This Thunder Cup is going to go up against up until Sunday. Yes, today you have two. We had two battles. Actually, we had one battle and having this battle right now. First battle was Werf vs Arcade, where Werf won perfectly. Now we have Fink vs Guard Officers. Whoever wins this match is going to go up against Arcade tomorrow. Tomorrow is only one match. And actually, let me check the timing here. Tomorrow's match is going to be at 7 p.m. CET. So pretty much the same time that tomorrow's first match started. And then we have the grand final on Sunday between Werf and whoever wins tomorrow's match. And that is definitely one final you do not want to miss out. Let's look at the team at the team ups here. GOF again not taken out aircraft. So far, they are missing one player, so they might still take out one aircraft. Fink Squadron going with the P-63C5. Two of them. Very good choice here, very good choice. And yeah, Fink Squadron went with two M4A3s, which, if I am not mistaken, should be going for B. Yes, indeed. Very predictable here. Oh, but GOF learned from their mistakes. GOF learned from their mistakes. They are going now three players over to B. They're taken from some fire from Ubojika and the other guy on the other side of the lake. But they seem fine so far. They haven't taken out any casualties so far. So GOF definitely learned from the past mistakes. They are completely ignoring the C flag. They are going for A and B. trying to use the same tactic that Fink used against him in the first battle. Meantime, Chippy is dropping a bomb on Bardock 7. Bardock 7 is trying to avoid it and... No, actually, no! He went for Neff! He went for Neff, but that was only a hit! He has Aether on his ass, let's see. How much damage did Neff take? Some minor damage, but it's going to be annoying. That's a damaged cannon barrel. He's going to take some time to repair that one. And that's exactly what he seems to be doing right now. And let's see, Aether also took out his bomb. Yes, Aether actually took out Sivir's one with his bomb. Very good bomb placement there. Dirtrop also set Paradox Salin on fire. Person here on this side of the river. Who is... Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Paradox Salin with a very jammed turd ring. And he only has two crew members left. One more shot and Paradox Salin is out of this game. Let's see how the battle is developing in the city. Field Somat is capping A for GOF, but he has Dirt Harbor and Ubojika to worry about on his left side. Sir over here having the fight of his life. He is very damaged though. This is a damaged turret ring. That's a dead gunner and a dead tank. See, Sir just got taken out by Dirt Harbor there. Dirt Harbor has proven himself to be a very strong player so far, I must say. I'm very impressed by this guy. But, and that's a big but. Well, not so much of a big but. GOF has initiated the bleed here, they have taken A, but it's going to be very hard for Field Somat to defend his flag if his mates from GOF do not take out B. And look at this, yep, GOF just lost the offensive on B, this is not looking good. These two guys are now going to go for B, and Field Somat is in a very, very bad position here. He has one tank in front, he has one tank behind him, and he has two tanks on the other side of the river. Field Somat, I'm sorry mate, you're not going to survive this one. Field Somat is in trouble here. The best he can do is start to take out one of the guys, but it's not looking good for him. It is not looking good. And Field Somat is down. Field Somat is down. Classic pincer maneuver here by Fink Squadron. They are now taking A. In the meantime, GOF went wise and they are going for the C. At least they can stop the bleed for a little bit. They can stop the bleed for a little bit. As long as Modern Unity doesn't cap this, they're not going to bleed, but Modern Unity is going straight for the cap circle. I must say, this is not looking good. But, oh, look at this, look at this. Psalm went into P63, but he doesn't have any bombs. He must have dropped his bombs before. Yes, yes, yes. If you catch the reference, just say ammo. So yeah, this is looking very, very bad for GOF. Fink with the perfect mode over here. They have two tanks over on the B flag. They took B. They are taking A. They have a very, very strong presence in the city. The only flag GOF has is C, but that did not help him out the last time either. I'm seeing some repetition here. This is not good. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, look at the GOF one for another aircraft. Paul Lurona in the TBF-1C. This is a fighter bomber. This has four 500-pound bombs. This can ideally take out four tanks. If it can reach it though, because remember here, he has Chippy to worry about. Chippy just camping in the spawn zone, just waiting for an aircraft to appear. He's just waiting for the opportunity to fire his guns and take something out. Now, social embassy hasn't changed too much yet. GOF is definitely not going for B. They just completely scrapped the idea to go for B. They have a strong presence here in the city, but they still have a lot of Fink Squadron members to worry about. We have Field Somat facing off against Ubojike and Haru Spice. Two guns against one. This is not looking good for Field Somat. He has taken no damage so far though. Very good angle here, I must say. And he took out Haru Spice. Very good, very good. Now there's only one tank to worry about. And look at this, ladies and gentlemen. If you don't know how to play tanks, look at this. Field Somat is being a amazingly strong player. Whilst Paul Aruna was actually shot down there, Paul Aruna did not manage to employ his bombs. Oh, Field Somat is actually on fire. Yeah, that's the thing. He was using this house here as perfect cover against the three guys over on that side. But as soon as he crossed it, he took a massive hit. His engine is down. He was on fire. Gladly, he did not take any damage to the crews, but this is going to take him some time. Time that GOF does not have. Look at the tickets. The tickets are going down, that's at least a quarter point down. But yo, oh, Field Somat actually takes up down Ubojika. Perfect shot placement there. Field Somat being the MVP here. But still, he now has to worry about Dershow and T-44 and the two guys over on the side of the river. His team is trying to back him off here. Again, oh, look at this, look at this. Silver's one against Eivor. Who's going to take this one? Eivor having some trouble. Yep, that's a dead loader. And Eivor is down. Silver takes the kill against Eivor. Oh, this is not looking for GOF. This is not looking for GOF. Look at this. GOF is down 4 plays already. In the meantime, Fink only has lost 1. I mean, come on. I really, really like GOF. I really like these guys. But they are just not having a good day today. They are just not having a good day today. Silver's one taking a massive hit there. He can still fire back, though. He can still fire back. He damaged Hero Spice enough to make him repair, but he can't stay here. He cannot stay here. In the meantime, they are losing C. GOF is losing C right now. Yeah, it seems like GOF, it seems like Fink Squadron is going to take this one again. But he took out Hero Spice. And he's not going to going down with the fight. And he just got taken out by Haru Spice. What? No, he was not. Actually, he was. Hero Spice somehow... Oh, I know exactly what happened. Hero Spice actually called in an artillery on him. Yes, artillery being used in these esports matches. And very effective, it seems. Artillery just security revenge kill on Silver's one there. Now, GF is desperately trying to go for the flag here, but look at that. They have TP behind him. TP, the MLG AA player. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. They're just hanging out. They're just hanging out. These guys are just hanging out like this. Just look at this, look at this, look at this. Alright. Come on. Tell me this isn't the definition of coolness. They don't even need armor. They're just enjoying the very good sun of Poland in the summer. The smell of Stalin wood in the air. And dead and burning tanks here. Actually, Chippy going around here. Did he not see those guys? Or what is he trying to do? He could have surprised Fink Squadron from behind there. Instead, he's going for the front. Chippy! Chippy! What are you doing? Chippy! Chippy! No! Chippy! I clear every team. So, feels so. Ooh! Ow! That was painful to watch. That was just painful to watch. Neff? Buddy? It's all on you now. You against 4. Yeah. This is the only guy left. Neff has the fight of his life on his hands. This is not a good, ladies and gentlemen, this is Fink versus GOF. It's currently 1-1, but GOF is not looking good here. It might just be that Fink Squadron is going to take this battle. Ooh, massive hitter, massive hit, gunner loaded, commander is down. One more shot and Neff is out of this battle. Ooh, that's a cannon breach, that's a cannon breach, he's still alive, he's still alive. Come on, come on, angle yourself, and he's on fire, come on, no. Turn trouble flanking around, this is nothing good. And yeah, just toying here. Turn trouble is just toying with him, and Neff is down. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. GOF just lost every single tank. Fifth Squadron takes the second win here. Amazing, just absolutely amazing. Now GOF is going to have the battle of their lives here on this hand. This is 2-1 for Fink Squadron. GOF has to win the next battle. If they lose the next battle, they are out of this tournament. And there's bye-bye chance of $11,000. Fink playing very strong here, I must say. I'm just extremely surprised by Fink Squadron here. They're playing so strong. But again, that's what you have to expect from these players here. These are professional esports teams. They are in the semifinals. They have proven themselves over and over again. And now, I must say, Fink would actually be in the winner's bracket if it wasn't for Arcade. They just had a very, very interesting battle against Arcade. And, well, Arcade took the bait there, but Arcade lost in the next battle. So, we might actually see a rematch here. If Fink wins this battle, they are going to face against Arcade for the second time, for the revenge match. Oh, that would be perfect, that would be perfect. But it's not over now. Ladies and gentlemen, let's not get ahead of ourselves. It's not over now. GOF still has a chance. They must win 2 battles, true. And they have the disadvantage in aircraft, true. But they are choosing this map. So they have the advantage in there, they have the home ground here. Now it seems that the teams have not yet chosen the maps. Field so map from... GOF Squadron seems to be taking out a map, but it's all in Russian, and ladies and gentlemen, I am not Russian, so I cannot read these maps here. Let's see what this says. Oh, apparently they took out a map that was not in the rotation. Let's see what they take instead. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, if you just tuned in, welcome to the second second finals of today. This is the losers bracket, Fink Squadron versus GOF. Whoever loses this one is out of the battle. Whoever wins this one is going to go up against Arcade, who lost the finals earlier on. My name is Michael Zwoom, and I am sadly your only commentator for today, because my dear co-commentators are, well, one of them is sick and the other one is busy, so yay, I'm all by myself. My mother is probably very proud of me.
This guy is just talking to himself. This is not how I raised this kid. He's a psychopath.
Alright, so it seems like we are going on Normandy. Again. Wow. Well, it is true that you have won the battle on Normandy. I think it was the second battle today. But. We've seen before that choosing the same map where we won at first isn't always a good idea. It is not always a good idea. Now, whilst we are waiting for these guys to start up, I'm actually going to read your chat here. Let's see what you guys have to say here. So, Liam Kirby really can't stand tank battles. Liam, what are you doing here? What are you doing here if you don't like tank battles? This is a very, very weird choice of you, but hey, I'm not judging you. Tom Driver Apple says GOF begins with last match with six people. Yes, this is actually a tactic they use. They always wait for Fink Squadron to completely get into the map, they scout out the enemy, and then choose the next vehicle according to that. So what you've seen up until now was Psalm from GOF Squadron always waiting, and depending on the number of aircraft or tanks, either taking out aircraft, or a tank, or even an anti-air vehicle. He's sort of the last man to get in. And ladies and gentlemen, the match is starting. This is match 3. Fink versus Guard Officers. Fink is leading 2-1 against GOF. And GOF is going to have a battle on their hands here. They have to win this one. This is match ball. If Fink wins this battle, they are up to the finals again. It's kind of a weird system. They're going to rematch against Arcade to get a chance at the grand final against Verve. Now, what's the match for this match? My English is leaving me here. Let's just quickly update that. So, yeah, match ball. Let's see how the teams are developing here. Pretty standard. Yeah, GF again with only 6 tanks. Chippy again with a P63. It might be that Psalm is going to take out a P63 in a bit as well. It seems like the teams have not changed the tactics too much here. Which, well, it might not be the best thing. GF has won the last battle on this map. Although, only very barely. GF only had 400 tickets left when they turned the game around. Given. It was amazing. It was very amazing to watch. They just clutched the game, took out Fink Squadron with 400 tickets left. Any minute more, they would have lost this battle. And I really hope we are not going to see the same thing again, because my heart cannot take it. I'm only 21 years old, and I would really not want to die of heart attack. I mean, I've drank so much coffee today, and I've seen so many exciting battles that I just really think my heart wouldn't take it. At the same time, I don't have pants anymore. I don't even know where my pants are. Since these last 3 streams, I have lost my pants. Now let's get back to the games here. This is getting weird, isn't it? So we have GOF taking out B again. Fink taking C again. Fink with a very strong presence in the city. GOF actually having some trouble here. They have only 3 tanks in the city. But they are still missing one player. Psalm has not yet spawned in. What is happening here? Psalm, where are you? I love you, mate. Marry me. No, don't. I can't marry an MLG player. That would be horrible. He would probably just play all day, every day. Anyways, yeah, we have Modern OT and Best Penny here, facing off against Artef. Artef is having a bad battle against him here. What is Modern OT fighting at here? Oh, he No, this seems to be a replay glitch here, yeah. Artef is on fire, Artef doesn't have a track. Takes another hit. Ooh, this is nothing good. Artef is down. Artef is not down yet. Never mind. Wow, I must say these T-34s are very resilient here. Well, that's you get for having Soviet tanks made out of strong stellium. The comrades. Best tank in the game. No Russian bias, ladies and gentlemen. over here we have Paul Laruna, feel so mad, sir. On the beach, facing off against Dirt Trouble and Ubo Zika. Artef just got taken down, so Facebook have the slight advantage here, but you have still they haven't taken out their one player here. What are they trying to do? In the meantime, Perfect Stanley is going to be in trouble very soon here. They have Ivar on the front end, never mind. Harris Boss was trying to go around, was trying to go to flank and to take Perfect Stanley from behind. Kinky. But it was not needed. Modern OG actually took him out. Actually no, it was Ivar who took him out first. So, GF just lost control over the city here. Modern OT is going for the capture. We see a repetition of the second battle here. This is very similar to what we've seen before. Yep, Modern OT taking the flag. They're now initiating the bleed here. Fizomite and Sir still on the beach here, but they're being held down by Ivar Zika and Haru Spice. As soon as they go over this crest, they're going to have Haru Spice to worry about. I think going with a very defensive position here. Look at this. This is some tanks, look at this. Here, four plays in a perfect line. Perfect defensive line. You have Haru Spice up front to give some very fast tactics for flanking around. Look at this. Sir is not even looking at him. Oh, and he takes one from behind and Sir is down. Haru Spice just flanks around perfectly here. And they got taken down. GF got completely annihilated on the beach. Hello. So that's the only chance they had. That was the only chance they had. Taken out. But they are still missing one player. Where is Psalm? Psalm is not in the game. Seriously. I mean, I'm not doubting GF here. I know that they are a strong tank, but that they are a very strong team, but not only are they handicapping themselves by almost never taking out aircraft, they also handicap themselves by waiting until 5 minutes into the game until Psalm finally spawned in. Okay, these are some unorthodox tactics, but I'm not going to doubt him here. Now, Chippy just spawned into a P63 C5. Where is he? He is very far away here. Did he do something? He did not. Oh well, let's look at the battles on the ground in the meantime. Perdlock Stanley facing off against Modern OT here. But yeah, Modern OT has the advantage here, and they are decapping B. Oh, this is just adding insult to injury, look at this. Fink Squadron, not only already dominating by points, already dominating in the tank game, they are already taking out the flag, the home flag of GOF, just accelerating the bleeding here. And Dirt Trouble is all by himself. Just holding off, feel some ads, sir. Pull Rona and Psalm here. Oh, just looking very, very bad here for GF Squadron. Modern OT, in the meantime, perfect side shot and turret of Paradox Stalin. Doc Stalin, what are you doing? You have now a gem turret. Archive is not in your. Oh! Double kill. Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, this might be it. This might just be it. Now Harris Spite is taking it from behind. He's on fire. This is some very hot, very fiery action from behind. Some taking them out, but Modern OT is still here. He's still holding the flank strong. Now Psalm is going around. What are these guys doing? Oh, they're going together though. No, you shouldn't be doing this. Ideally, they would be splitting up. One going through here and the other going flanking around, but they are not doing that. They are sticking together. And that might just prove they are doing here. Oh, I know exactly what they're doing. I take that back. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. They are actually trying to flank around Ubo Zika here. Very smart, but they are losing time. They've already lost half of the points. Dirt Trouble is still holding them off here. Still holding them off. feel so mad. Fizmat did not take any damage, but he's not advancing. They must advance now. GF has to advance or they're going to lose this battle. They are running out of tanks. They are running out of place to play with here. Psalm just took a hit. Psalm is in trouble here. This is not looking good. Psalm unable to move his turret. Unable to fire back. And Psalm is down. Psalm is down. GF just lost another player here. This is nothing good for GF. Actually, oh, here we see Sir. Sir trying to flank around. Sir trying to finally dislodge Dirt Chopper here from the B flag. But is it going to be enough? Dirt Chopper knows he's here. Dirt Chopper knows he's here. He's already waiting for him. And Filsomet is advancing now. Dirt Chopper is in trouble. Dirt Chopper is in trouble. He is now between two tanks. Two guns firing at him. And he can only punch the Sir one way at a time. But Sir is also being flanked around. Look at this clutch play from Ubujika. Saving his teammate. Sir is down. Sir is on fire. Sir is on fire. This is not looking good for him. Who's going to take the first battle here? Dirt Chopper facing off against Filsomet. Dirt Chopper sets Sir on fire. First, Sir is unable to fire back at the moment. Ubujika has the perfect side shot here. Bounces off against Ubujika. Dirt Chopper is still facing off against Filsomet. Pull around, going around with the off-twins. But he's only in an AA. What can he do? Oh my god, we see some epic Donald and we see some T-Bang here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is tank on tank T-Bang. Dirt Chopper takes out Filsomet. Sir is in trouble here. Sir is in trouble. He's facing off pretty much alone against two tanks. Ubujika from the side. Dirt Chopper in the front. Sir actually critically damaged Dirt Chopper here. He gets some time, but look at the points. Look at the points, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the points. Ubujika is also repairing. Her Spice coming from behind. Dirt Chopper is repairing. Uber Spice is repairing. Austin just got taken out by the P63. Sir is now the only player left alive on GOF, and he's down. Ladies and gentlemen, this was epic. This was epic. Those last 2 minutes were all worth it. And that was it. Fink takes a third win. Fink takes out GOF. I must catch my breath here. Oh my god. I hope you guys are excited at home, because I know I am sweating right now. I am sweating right now. So let me look at the charts here. If I'm not mistaken, yeah, GOF is out. GOF is out of Thunder Cup. Fink Squadron takes the win and qualifies for the face-off against Arcade tomorrow. Now remember, Fink Squadron lost against Arcade. Arcade put him in the losers bracket, but Arcade lost the last finals. So they are going to have a rematch here. Tomorrow is going to be very interesting to see what these teams are going to do. They're going to face off against each other one more time. For the last chance to get into Grand Finals. For the last chance to face off against Verve. And for the very last chance to win the trip to China. To face off against the Chinese team. And to win $11,000. Oh my. Now, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow's match is going to be at 19 PM CET. So pretty much the same time it was today. Actually, no. 9 PM GMT. Pretty much the same time that the first match was taken on. My god. My god. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Michael's Boom. I'm out of words here. I'm just out of words. I really hope you enjoyed the stream. And you can see me tomorrow. Tomorrow, same time, I'm going to be streaming this again with either Sean or the Orange Doom. Either way, stay tuned for tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be an epic match. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.